students, today we are going to perform a practical in which we are going to prepare and evaluate herbal shampoo. So, what are ingredients of this herbal shampoo? First of all, we are using methi seeds in the quantity of 2.5 gram, which is act as an anti-dandruff agent. Then second thing, we are using shikakai, which is used in 10 gram quantity, which has cleaning property as well as it is effective for the conditioning effect. Then third ingredient is orange peel. We are using orange peel powder, which is act as a perfuming agent, and it also has some conditioning properties. Then next thing is Retha, which is act as a foaming agent to improve the foam as well as it acts as an emulsifying agent also. Then water as a vehicle, which is used as about 20 ml, quantity sufficient to 20 ml. Then by using this formula, we are going to perform our or we are going to prepare our shampoo. Then for the evaluation of standardization of our shampoo, we are going to perform following tests. In first test, we are going to study physical appearance as a, of that particular shampoo, whether it is its consistency is proper or not, that is visual inspection. Then second test, we are going to determine the pH of that shampoo. While determining pH, we are taking 10% volume by volume shampoo and using water as a vehicle, and we are going to determine the pH of that particular solution. Then third test, we are going to perform foam test, which is very important test when we are going to study or standardize any type of cleansing product such as shampoo, soaps or detergent, etc. So foaming index is most important test while evaluation of shampoos. Then third dispersion test. This is a second test in which we are going to determine whatever formulation we are going to prepare, this formulation or this shampoo is how much effective to clean the dirt which is present on the hair. So this dirt determine or dirt dispersion test we can perform in by using two methods. First method, we can directly use the hair sample on which we can apply this shampoo and we can clean it to determine dirt test. Or second test, if you don't have any hair sample, so we can use Indian ink, and in that Indian ink we are adding shampoo and we are going to shake it for 10 times. We are going to shake it for 10 times. After shaking it, we have whatever ink we have added to it, it should be dispersed uniformly and the color of ink should be fade. So if it is fade, it means our shampoo has a dirt dispersion property. If it doesn't fade, it means our shampoo doesn't have proper dirt dispersion property. Then next test is wetting test or wetting time. In that test, if we are going to use any shampoo for the cleansing purpose, how much time it requires to clean or to disperse or to wet the particular area. So we are going to perform this wetting time test. In that we are using one disc paper which is about 1.5 inches size, and we are calculating time at in what time this paper will be wet and settled down in the our given shampoo. So this is known as a wet dispersion test. So this five tests are we are going to perform for the evaluation of our prepared herbal shampoo. Let's see how to prepare our shampoo.
Okay, so we are going to prepare shampoo. First of all, we have taken 2.5 gram of methi seeds. This is our methi seed powder. Then second ingredient is our shikakai powder, which is I have weighed it. It is 10 gram of shikakai powder. I have mixed Okay. Next, we are going to add a pinch of orange peel powder, which acts as a perfuming agent. Then, last but not least, it is a Retha powder, which is act as a foaming agent. We are going to mix all this powder in the in the dry form. After After that, we are gradually mixing a water in it. While mixing water, we have to take care that it should be continuously, there should be a continuous trituration so that consistency of shampoo will be obtained. If you have mixed all the water at a single time, it will not form a proper shampoo. It will form two different phases. So we have to add water while triturating and in small quantity. Proper trituration is very important step in the preparation of shampoo. Now you can see it is completely mixed and it has obtained the consistency of shampoo. The next step, we are going to pour this shampoo in the beaker and we want to adjust the weight. We want to adjust the volume of this shampoo up to 20 ml. So I am adding here some water and we want to make up the volume. So our shampoo is ready. Now if you are going to pack it in a container, you have to shake it in the container so it will get uniformly dispersed throughout the face.